like, share, comments and subscribe. Amjad Ali, BSc, NRN. Chronic Inflammatory Bowel Disease, IBD. Definition: the term inflammatory bowel disease, IBD, is used to identify two chronic inflammatory GI disorders, regional enteritis, i.e. Crohn's disease, and ulcerative colitis. Ulcerative colitis. Ulcerative colitis is an inflammatory bowel disease, IBD, that causes long-lasting inflammation and ulcers, sores, in your digestive tract.
Ulcerative colitis is a disease that causes inflammation and sores, called ulcers, in the lining of the rectum and colon.
Ulcerative colitis is an inflammatory bowel disease that spans the entire length of the colon and involves only mucosa and submucosa. The disease usually starts in the rectum and distal colon and involves sigmoid and descending colon. Epidemiology. Incidence, 8 to 15 per 100,000 persons. Prevalence, 170 to 230 per 100,000. Onset is most common between ages of 15 to 40. Ulcerative colitis affects male and females equally and appears to run in some families. Etiology and risk factors. Causes: bacterial origin, genetic factors, altered immunity, allergic reaction. The exact cause of ulcerative colitis remains unknown. Previously, diet and stress were suspected, but now doctors know that these factors may aggravate but don't cause ulcerative colitis. Risk factors. Ulcerative colitis affects about the same number of women and men. Risk factors may include age. Ulcerative colitis usually begins before the age of 30. But, it can occur at any age, and some people may not develop the disease until after age 60. Race or ethnicity. Although whites have the highest risk of the disease, it can occur in any race. If you're of Ashkenazi Jewish descent, your risk is even higher. Family history. You're at higher risk if you have a close relative, such as a parent, sibling or child, with the disease. Pathophysiology. The most characteristic lesion of UC is an inflammatory infiltrate called crypts. This abscess consists of leukocytes, lymphocytes, red cells and cellular debris and purulent discharge. Infection secondary to UC produce further inflammatory reactions in the mucosa and submucosa. When inflammatory reactions heal, scarring and fibrosis appears. Digestive enzymes and intestinal bacteria act upon this exposed tissue, causing further irritation, inflammation, ulceration and bleeding. Clinical manifestations. Ulcerative colitis symptoms can vary, depending on the severity of inflammation and where it occurs. Signs and symptoms may include diarrhea, often with blood or pus with tenesmus. Rectal bleeding, abdominal pain and cramping, urgency to defecate, rectal pain, weight loss, diarrhea, often with blood or pus, with tenesmus, fatigue, inability to defecate despite urgency, fever. Diagnosis, physical examination, histopathological examination, blood tests. Blood tests to check for anemia, a condition in which there aren't enough red blood cells to carry adequate oxygen to your tissues, or to check for signs of infection. Stool sample. White blood cells in your stool can indicate ulcerative colitis. A stool sample can also help rule out other disorders, such as infections caused by bacteria, viruses and parasites. Colonoscopy. This exam allows your doctor to view your entire colon using a thin, flexible, lighted tube with an attached camera. During the procedure, your doctor can also take small samples of tissue, biopsy, for laboratory analysis. Sometimes a tissue sample can help confirm a diagnosis. Flexible sigmoidoscopy. Your doctor uses a slender, flexible, lighted tube to examine the rectum and sigmoid, the last portion of your colon. If your colon is severely inflamed, your doctor may perform this test instead of a full colonoscopy. X-ray. If you have severe symptoms, your doctor may use a standard X-ray of your abdominal area to rule out serious complications, such as a perforated colon. CT scan. A CT scan of your abdomen or pelvis may be performed if your doctor suspects a complication from ulcerative colitis. A CT scan may also reveal how much of the colon is inflamed. Complications. Inflammation of your skin, joints and eyes, severe bleeding and increased risk of colon cancer, perforated colon, a rapidly swelling colon, toxic megacolon, severe dehydration, risk of blood clots in veins and arteries, liver disease, rare. Medical management, non-surgical management, diarrhea management, drug therapy, which include antidiarrheal, corticosteroids, antibiotics, antispasmodics, and anticholinergic and opioid analgesics. Diet therapy, rest. Surgical treatment. Surgery may include total colectomy with ileostomy, segmental colectomy with anastomosis, subtotal colectomy, total colectomy with continent ileostomy, and total colectomy with ileoanal anastomosis. Nursing management, nursing diagnosis, alteration in comfort, i.e. pain, RT, inflamed mucosa, diarrhea, RT, inflamed intestinal mucosa, knowledge deficit, RT, surgical procedure and possible ileostomy and bowel resection, ineffective coping, RT, disturbance of body image and self-concept secondary to ostomy, risk for fluid volume anxiety. Nursing interventions, enhance nutritional status, promote nursing care of the client who is receiving nothing by mouth, receiving oral fluids, or on total parenteral nutrition during an acute exacerbation. Assess for fluid and electrolyte imbalance. Administer IV fluids and electrolytes as indicated. Encourage a low-residue, high-protein, high-calorie diet with supplemental vitamin therapy and iron replacement. Implement measures to treat diarrhea or constipation. Foods to limit or avoid: limit dairy products, limit fiber, if it's a problem food avoid other problem foods. Spicy foods, alcohol and caffeine may make your signs and symptoms worse. Eat small meals, drink plenty of liquids. Stress management techniques, perianal skin care, minimize pain. Address and mediate the client's pain. Promote intermittent rest periods and bed rest when the client has acute exacerbations. Exercise, even mild exercise, can help reduce stress, relieve depression, and normalize bowel function. Biofeedback. This stress reduction technique helps you reduce muscle tension and slow your heart rate with the help of a feedback machine. Regular relaxation and breathing exercises. Subscribe to our YouTube channel.